Hello everyone, myself Dr. Narahari Malgaonkar. I am a Chief IVF Consultant at Progenesis Fertility Center. So today we are going to talk about a very advanced technology in the IVF, which we can say as a breakthrough for the treatment of male infertility, that is called as the ICSI. So we should know about what is the ICSI technology is, and we should know about when to use the ICSI technology and how we can improve the result of IVF with the help of ICSI technology. So first, we should know what is exactly the ICSI. So it is an advanced technology in the IVF. So that is called as an intracytoplasmic sperm injection. So normally what we do, so we take out the oocytes in the IVF. And after taking out the oocytes, we take the husband sperm and we inject single sperm into the single oocytes. So that is called as an intracytoplasmic sperm injection. So which is an advanced technology. So as I say, it is a breakthrough for the male infertility. So what are the indications? So when we have to use this technology and how we can improve the result with this technology? So what are the indications if we say? So if there is a severe oligoacinoteratozoospermia, if the male factors, so sperm count or motility, morphology, we cannot improve with the help of medication. So in that condition, even though there is a very low sperm count, we can use those spermatozoa for the ICSI. So in that condition, again, as I say, the motility is even on the lower side, we can choose a good quality of sperm and we can inject that sperm into the oocyte. So that again, even though very severe oligoacinoteratozoospermia, ICSI gives a very good results. So what is the next indication? If there is a fertilization failure in the IVF, even the normal sperm count, but there is a total fertilization failure or we cannot get a good quality of embryo in the IVF. So in that condition, ICSI gives a very good results. If there is a multiple IVF failure or fertilization failure in the IVF, again ICSI plays a very important role. As I say, if there is azoospermia, there is no sperm. So in that condition, we take out the sperm from the testes. That is called as a sperm retrieval techniques like TISA, PISA or micro TISA. So after taking out those sperms are the non-motile sperm. So after taking out that sperm, we inject that sperm into the oocyte and we can develop a very good quality of embryo. So even there is no sperm in the male, so we can retrieve the sperm and we can use that sperm with the help of ICSI. We can develop very good embryos and that couple can have their own baby. So if there is a sperm, as I said, with the cryptozoospermia or there is a globozoospermia for the male spermatozoa. So in that condition, again, ICSI plays a very important role. So as I say, so these are the indications. So male factors is a very important, as a, even though is very severe problem in the male or there is azoospermia, with the help of ICSI technology, we can get a good quality of embryo and we can improve the fertilization rate. And if we get a good quality of embryo, so automatically there is increase in the chances of implantation and the pregnancy. So with the help of this technology, the result in the IVF are much better and basically for the male infertility. So this is, as I say, it's a very good technology, and with this technology we can improve the result to a next extent. Thank you.